prices of growth that they know say for 10 or 20 years or longer? How often are they swindled by family members and relatives?
All right, let's talk about some basic things. There are similarities in many of the stories in your book. It's a good read because by reading it, you'll get familiar with techniques that these con artists have in common. Who's most likely to get scammed by a con artist, according to what you've seen?
Well, I think generally anyone who's lost money the last few years is extremely vulnerable. And that's a lot of people. And what we find is when you've lost money, you become a little bit more desperate to try to earn your money back. You know, especially if they've made close to retirement or so, you say, wait, I'm down 20%, I'm down 30%, what am I going to do? And so you're susceptible to the scam artists, and they know that they've moved in on it. The second group of people that's extremely vulnerable, and this is kind of more and more of a life day by day as a boomer's age, are people who are getting older, who are elderly. What happens is you start to lose some of your perceptive abilities, you become lonely. A lot of these people, they live alone, they don't have family members nearby, and they're extremely vulnerable to being preyed on by people who try to win over their trust. And then finally, people who are going through periods of grief, what we call it the bereave. If you just had a family member who's passed away, if your spouse has died, of course you're not altogether emotionally stable in it because of what you just got through. And these scam artists, they know that. They prey on them.
All right, so if you know somebody who's recently bereaved or somebody who's getting older, try and stay involved at least in having them talk to you about what is going on in their lives and who's trying to invest for them. Tell me about the strategies that these con artists use to scam average people. Give us some warning signs.
Well, the first thing is that these are very false emotional bonds they will try to create. They will come in, they'll tell you things like, hey, I've known your father for all these years. Hey, you know, you and I go back ages back to high school. Remember when we used to do this and this? Or don't you remember when we used to sit next to each other in church? So they'll try these emotional bonds, which are often work, and then they'll move in with promises of very good returns. That say you can maybe double your money, or you might get 15% return a year in a market like right now, where interest rates are extremely low. And so that's very suspicious.
One of the things that was interesting in your book is that people in Europe did this, and Ponzi did this. This idea that I have a new way of investing. The old way doesn't work, even though everybody else can't get to more than, 10% in a great year on the market. I got some other way that hasn't been discovered.
Well, that's why, that's what we call sort of the idea of the new paradigm, the new economy. And so going back to the late 1990s and into 2000, the regular model was sort of private pet stocks. Remember the pet.com. Company and things like this. And these were sold, investors would say, wait a second, there's a company that's not really making money. How could they be doing this? But the response would be, don't worry, this is a new economy we're in now. This is a new theory. This is a new product. And so these types of things will often cost investors.
All right, great book, worth reading. Financial Serial Killers, Inside the World of Wall Street, Money Hustlers, Swindlers, and Con Men, co-authored by my good friend Tom Edgman. Thank you, Tom.
Thank you, Alex.
Building Up Mississippi by Singing and Playing the Blues. We'll have that story and a very surprising look at Tom Foreman coming up next. You do not want to know.
I just wanted to look around. So I went on Ancestry.com to see if I could find my great-grandfather. It was unbelievable. I found all kinds of historical documents, including a census record that showed that he was the town of Milwaukee.
Visit Ancestry.com and discover the world's largest online family history resource.
You really don't have to know what you're looking for. You just have to start looking.
Your discovery starts right now on Ancestry.com.
I'm from the Gulf Coast. My family spends a lot of time there. I have a personal interest in ensuring that we get this job done right. I'm Chief Theon. I'm in charge of BP's cleanup on the Gulf Coast. BP's taken full responsibility for the cleanup, and that includes keeping you informed. Over 25,000 people are included in the cleanup operation. Our crews are cleaning Gulf beaches 24/7. We're going to be here as long as it takes to make this right.
No one moves a truck the way GM's engineers do. That's why this year is engineered.